Now we come to the ventricles of the brain. There is a big lateral ventricle which has a body which has an anterior horn which goes in relation to the frontal lobe, has a posterior horn which goes in relation to the occipital lobe, and has a big inferior horn which goes in relation to the temporal lobe of the brain. So body with its extension, anterior horn, posterior horn, and a big inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. The structures in relation to the lateral ventricle is the caudate nucleus, the thalamus, the thalamostriate vein. Then there is another ventricle, which is the third ventricle, which is present in between the thalami of the adjacent cortex, cerebral cortex. The lateral ventricle and the third ventricle are communicating with each other by an interventricular foramen. From the third ventricle, there is a continuous cavity which is known as the aqueduct of Sylvius, which lies in relation to the midbrain, and then it continues down into the fourth ventricle of the brain. The fourth ventricle of the brain is a small cavity which is present between the cerebellum above and the pons and medulla below. The cerebellum is forming the roof and the pons and medulla are forming the floor of this small cavity, which is known as the fourth ventricle. It is continuous above with the cerebral aqueduct, and below it is continuous with the central canal of the spinal cord.